Good afternoon, everybody. Tommy O'Brien filling in for my dad. And we got markets in red territory for today. We got a treat. We got our man Fred Ernest. He's coming up for Vista Gold at about 20 past the hour. But we have enough going on in this market to keep us busy. We're going to jump to retail sales in a moment. Just did the market recap. We got red across the board right now. You have higher yields. You have some dollar strength. We have the S&Ps right now trading lower by 38 points. That is 0.8% in the red. And we're 13 points off the low. So you were a solid 50 points at the lows in this market coming into about 2 p.m. Eastern time. And boy, you got lower lows and lower highs in this market as we're facing a little bit of a repricing potentially of where the Fed is going to be in terms of their schedule of cutting as we go forward from there. Just making sure. No, I'm not hearing an echo to my producer to let me know. Hopefully everything seems like it's good. I'm hearing something, but things seem to be going well. We are in the den. All right, something's going on in the den. All right, looks like they got something going on in the den, but we are good with Tiger TV. We march on. Let's jump to the dollar index. We jump around DXY right now. Dollar 103.45 right now. We're as high as 103.69. And to my producers, just let me know if I need to do anything on my end. I think they're going to get it figured out. Let's jump to retail sales, folks, because it was a strong one. It kicked off the trading day, and we have retail sales up 0.6% for the month of December. Excluding autos, sales rose 0.4%. The numbers they were looking for were well below that. And you look at the trend, man, when we come in, relentlessly strong. Very difficult to imagine that the Fed is going to be able to take their foot off of the pedal so quickly when you have an economy that is just so strong across the board. All right, I talked a little bit about this one in the morning, but if you didn't catch the program, just wanted to touch on it. Because, boy, it's a big one, man. From the Journal, they're talking about the bills coming due on a record amount of commercial real estate debt. And you check it out, man. The number is $2.2 trillion. That's coming due between now and at the end of 2027. You look at the expectations for what they're looking for in terms of defaults. 2023, this is U.S. commercial mortgage-backed securities loan delinquency. You're talking about 3.5% about is where you were as of November 30th. For mortgage-backed securities, and that number, come on, cooperate. When you get into 2024, you're talking about 8%, folks. You get into 2025, you're talking about 10%. So keep this in mind as we march forward as well. But strong retail sales out there, and this is one of the things the Fed is dealing with, man. They know these numbers are coming up. Those rate cuts cannot come quick enough for the commercial mortgage area. And yeah, as long as we have retail sales plowing ahead, though, at 0.6% in the month of December, we'll see where we go from there. But the yields are speaking. I interviewed our man Teddy Kegstad on the program this morning. You know, he's talking about bonds, right? He's talking about yields. You got to pay attention. He had been talking about the weeks prior, saying, listen, you got to pay attention to what those numbers are doing. And we've had quite the pullback the last couple of days. So pay attention to that move, man. Yesterday, today, an extension of that move, we're trading at 111.14 right now. All right, we jump around what else we have going on in this market. We take a look at some of the big equities. Apple saving itself a bit, up about $2 off of the lows. Still negative by about 0.7%. Microsoft overtaking Apple as the biggest company in the world, off about 0.5%, off of $1.89. Got to talk a little Tesla, right? They're cutting prices yet again. Tesla down 2.2% right now. JetBlue and Spirit yesterday, man. I mean, if you didn't get out of JetBlue yesterday when you got a gift, that's unfortunate. Wouldn't fault you. Maybe you thought it got a little bit of carry through, right? Saving all that money, not buying Spirit. Not the case, man. JetBlue, below where you were as of yesterday coming into that news, they're negative by 8.6% today. And you jump over to Spirit, 24%, man. And that's as of yesterday's close. Okay, you caught a bid to $8. No, you're back down to $6, excuse me. Just like that, you're down 25% off of yesterday's close. This thing was trading near 15 coming into that news event that thing got overturned. And they got a big, tough path ahead of themselves in terms of how they're going to survive that one as they were pending on that deal. And we'll see how that goes forward. They're going to get something like $500 million from JetBlue if that deal gets blocked, which it looks like it will. But nonetheless, Max Payne. You jump over to some of those chip stocks, hot yesterday, and clawing back some of those losses of today. You talk about volatility, man. NVIDIA shares. Yeah, you're off by $5.60, but you were down to $5.50. That was at the open as of yesterday, right? Still off by about 1% right now for NVIDIA. AMD had a heck of a day yesterday. continues higher, up about 0.5%. Intel, not the same deal, man, right? Down 2.5%. Do not confuse these companies. Now, Intel had quite a run last year, 25 up to 50. AMD, you're talking about 60 up to 160, though. Quite a different world. And we know the NVIDIA story, of course, from 100 up to almost 600 at this point. 568, the all-time high this week. Pretty remarkable. All right, we jump around to the dollar index. We keep our eye on yields. You get the dollar right now. Giving up some of those gains, pretty much where we were at about 8 a.m. this morning, 103.45. We made it as high as 103.69. We take a look at the 10-year right now, and you get the 10-year just chopping around, basically, 111.15. All right, let me see what else I had pulled up as we jump around. Yeah, we can talk a little bit of Bitcoin. Let's talk a little bit of Boeing first. I was just joking with friends. I mean, they're on quite a run right now. Boeing, not sure this is even their fault as it goes forward, but they make the headline. Because if you're making headlines right now and a Boeing plane breaks down and the Secretary of State gets stranded, that headline writes itself. Blinken stranded after Boeing 737 breaks down on Davos trip. Nonetheless, that story out today. We take a look at Boeing. They were higher pre-market. Yeah, and they hold on to some of those gains, giving up some of them as well. You're positive by $1.80, up 0.9%, sitting at 202. And we've been talking about this equity, man. You take a look at this thing. We're just sitting right at this area of basic support from the beginning of 2023. You chopped around between 200 and 220 for a period of almost 7 months for Boeing. Broke out of there, traded back low to 180, and where are you? You're right back to 200. How long did it take? A few days practically, right? We were sitting at 245 on January 5th. 12 days later, we're sitting at 202. Pretty remarkable. All right, folks, we got the S&Ps negative by 42. I mean, boy, I talked to our man Tim Ord yesterday on this program. If you didn't catch that interview, you can check it out on our YouTube page. We archive all the interviews we do. And he had some great ratios, man, looking at the VIX, looking at the SPY. You look at this chart, not a strong top as we potentially are rolling over right now. And that tied into some of his SPY VIX ratios. And boy, I bet you're getting a spike today because we get the VIX over 15 at 15.11 with the market selling off. All right, folks, stay tuned. We're going to be coming back. We're going to be talking to our man, Fred Earnest, president and CEO of Vista Gold. We'll get an update of what they got going on. We'll talk a little bit of gold. Don't go away, folks. We'll be right back.